VocaLAB Productions. In all my adventures in time and space, I never get time to read. I collect books like I collect friends, untold stories, and unlimited possibilities gathering dust, each tome representing lives I've left untouched, lives I can say I had no part in ruining. There's a collection of books in this hollow library, a crime noir series, Melody Malone. Holding these pulp stories in my hands helps me to feel a connection to the people within the pages, the minds and hearts behind the typewriter ink. Wait, what's this? An Ex Libris, a bookplate. I've never seen this before. Not in the Melody Malone books, very crude artist rendering of the TARDIS. And of course, the windows are wrong. Always. No focus, Doctor. Look again. These markings embedded into the art itself. It looks like a QR code. Could be a fancy reprint from the future. A silly little marketing gimmick. Let's see when this book was published. 1941. It's an original. No. But then that must mean... Come on, wakey wakey! I need you to give this a gander. Here. Ah. Of course. Oh, Amy.
Doctor, I hope this works. It's been a while since that afterword, and I couldn't leave you like that. There had to be a way of speaking to you again. Rory suggested to try embedding something in these book plates. Something only you can read. So here we are. Me and you. Time and space. The next page. So, quick catch-up. After a month in NYC, we managed to find an apartment, and Rory got a small-time job as a grocery boy. Oh my god, you should see him in his green apron. So cute. For the past 4 years, we're trying to make the best of things, because we know the bad times are coming. It's 1941, about a week after the Pearl Harbor bombings. The scary thing is that although me and Rory know what's going to happen, we're not like you. We can't save the day or give these people hope. We have to ride out the storm. I'll continue to write these letters and hide them in however many books I write. So while you're saving the universe, keep an eye out for my books, would you, Doctor? With love, Amy. P.S. Rory says hi and asks if you can hide some gold somewhere so he can stop being a grocery boy.
Where are you? Nope. Oh, not that. Oh. No, this is ridiculous. Ah, here we are. That's it. Let's go and shift that and... Whoa. Whoa. Oh.
Close one. Oh, that's it. Now.
Hello, Pond. Only you would find a way to bend the rules. Neat trick with a QR code. I suppose Rory still has his smartphone. Just be sensible, okay? Anyway, so glad to be hearing from you and Rory. You're lucky I have a time-appropriate means of correspondence. Remember that old crummy typewriter you threw into the TARDIS cupboard for a laugh? Well, it wasn't just for show. I borrowed it from an old Dalton Trumbo. He needed a writing break. He was getting too wrinkly from writing in the bathtub. Anyway, yes, I'm keeping well. You know how it is. I'd run out of paper telling you everything I've been up to. Though, speaking of paper, I followed a paper trail of psychic assassins, and I folded their operation. anyway, happy times and places. The Doctor. P.S. It's a no-can-do on the gold. I donated my own 2 bags worth of gold dust on New Year's Eve, 1999.
Dear Doctor, if you kept your promise, you'll be reading this. You found my first letter and I couldn't be happier, except that you're 5 years too late. The war is over now, and we're stood in Times Square on Victory Day, just missed being photographed. Some hunky sailor and his gal got there first. But I have a feeling that if we were photographed, you'd have a crossy face. Oh, I'm smirking thinking about it now. After being in all the bars and amongst the people, it helped me realise something. We never experienced the times and places we went to. Being trapped here gives me and Rory that time. Time to breathe. Time to recalibrate. To rethink things. These letters are a next page for you. But it's a whole new chapter for me and Rory. Missing you, Raggedy Man. Amy.
Hello, Pond! Sorry about the late letter. Time-travelling post is a mystery unto itself. My magazine subscriptions never arrive on time. But yes, Victory Day. Fabulous. Lots of confetti, people, kissing. Happy, happy stuff. I'm pleased to read that you have a smidge of responsibility, Miss Amelia. Having you and Rory snogging as an iconic image of American culture would be a bit like me sharing an image of jammy Dodgers on the Empire State girder. Oh, put a pin in that. I'll get the photographer to crop the photo. Anyway, it's a trickier business looking for these bookplates than I thought. I scoured the TARDIS library's collection of your books and I only had the one with this bookplate. So began my search. I do love a good dive into a car boot sale, especially ones on the found Moon of Poosh. Oddly enough, still called car boots, despite there being no cars on the found Moon of Poosh. Yes, about that too, it was formerly lost for a while and I sorted it a lifetime ago. Now they're proud enough to refer to it as the found Moon of Poosh. I hope you have found your true happiness, Amelia. Because I can sense you're missing something. I'm not sure what, because, well, I'm no Van Gogh. Till the next time, the Doctor. P.S. I do not appreciate seeing a ghastly artist rendition of that Dalek asylum. I wanted to burn this book, but that would have had me locked up.
Dear Doctor, this time only a month later for your letter. About how you ended it, though. I don't think I'm missing anything, per se, as I wrote the next book. Actually, I've got writer's block. Rory got no end of questions. I may as well have been a Dalek with my interrogations. Just imagine that with a Dalek voice that sounds less Scottish-American. It was after that I decided what the bookplate design should be. It was on that Dalek asylum where I snapped at Rory. Said things, did things I regret. Now that we have a new chapter in our lives, we wanted to show someone the universe. as much as humanly possible anyway, and give someone a chance for something better, like you did for the two of us. We applied to adopt a child together. It's only a year later, but families are torn up and struggling to rebuild. People here see adoption as a luxury. It's sick, if you ask me. It's not like getting a dog or a rabbit. Anyway, we applied to a program adopting babies left behind by families that either gave them up or their parents are gone. Our first day visiting, and we found him. The child we wanted to adopt. Anthony. Barely weeks old, but he saw us, looking over him like we'd fallen out of the sky. I'd never seen Rory smile and cry so much after Anthony smiled back at him. We've said Anthony was who we wanted, and we're just waiting to see if we're suitable. Wish we could have put you as a reference, but oh well. I'll let you know if we're accepted. With love, Amy, Rory, and hopefully, baby Anthony.
Oh, Amy, that's wonderful to hear. Giving life a new chance is such a brave and brilliant thing. I know you and Rory will be A+ parents. You've stood by each other through thick and thin, and Daleks, Cybermen, actually, maybe not them. But you've mostly survived 97% of the battles you've fought. Raising a child in the 20th century shouldn't be too hard, eh? Sending you the best of luck, the Doctor.
Doctor, your letter came the next week, and we've been approved. We've named him Anthony Brian Williams, after his granddad from the future. Anthony will be home in a week. I'm writing to you in his bedroom, half painted, because Rory's mucking about with the phone and recording cute videos. I should be angry, but I just can't. He's going to be such a great dad. Because he's been the best husband. And my best friend. He's recorded 4 so far. To tell him all about us. And you. I hope that's okay. The world should know about you. But Anthony is my world now. And I can tell you this, Doctor. I'm scared. My last time being a mother was stolen from me. Like my soul was ripped out of me. I want the best for Anthony. To inspire him and love him with as much of myself as I have left. All that time ago, Starship UK, I should have seen it then. But you have a magic with children. You were my imaginary friend. How can I compare to you? How can I inspire Anthony? Love, Amy. P.S. What shade of blue actually is the TARDIS? I'm going to send Rory to find some cans of it after I shout at him.
Dear Pond, tell him the best bedtime stories in the universe. Every night for as long as you can. The stories of our lives, the stories that made us. Despite everything, you're still you, Amy Pond. And you are enough. Trust me. I'm finding it harder and harder to find your bookplates, Pond. So many editions to keep track of, so many charity shops and book clubs joined. I've counted about 15 establishments where I've been booted out for using a typewriter. Excuse me, there's 2 angry managers looming over me. Make it 16. Truth be told, you don't really need my advice. When you hold that baby in your arms, those broken pieces of you will mend together. Like the torn pages of this copy I'm looking at, there's lots of notes and scribbles. Your words on these pages and these books have changed lives. For the better. P.S. Might be late, but between me and you and Rory, it's Pantone 2955C. the shade of blue for the TARDIS. But keep it hush. It's a Time Lord secret. The Doctor. Dear Amy, it's been months, maybe years in relative time since your last bookplate. I fear you might have stopped writing. Which I'm okay with. You have your new life now with little Anthony and Rory. How's Anthony adjusting to life with the Ponds / Williams? I'm sure you're doing great things, seeing great places. Just like I hope you would. Ah, a delivery! Brilliant. Another used copy. I should have just ordered online from the start. Don't need this. Ah. What's next from Pond?
Dear Doctor, typing to you from London 1965. We finally saved up. And from the book sales, we took a flight all the way back home. It's a weird feeling to wander in what's going to be your home in a little over 40 years. Although we've been in the past nearly 20 years now, we wanted to show Anthony the world. He's grown up so fast. After this trip to London, he's travelling for his gap year. He's studying a journalism degree inspired by our stories. Oh, you should have seen the joy on his face when he saw a real-life police box. It was standing there, far too small to be yours, and it had an out-of-order sign hanging from the door. But Anthony was drawn to it. Could it have been yours? We didn't want to risk anything, so we left. The rest of the trip felt odd. Like we'd walked over our graves, being so close to you again, but knowing that you were so far away. After the trip out, it was just me and Rory in the hotel. We talked things over and realised that we weren't getting any younger here. Rory practically begged to write a letter of some kind. I gave in. Now Rory's in the next room. He needed to be alone to write. After seeing our back and forth letters, he wanted to write a letter to the most important man in the universe. His dad. Brian. Have you even told him about what happened to us? It's okay if not. It was hard enough losing us. Having to open up that old wound would be too much for you. Love, Amy.
Dear Pond, glad to catch your letter. Almost 2 decades. Wowza. Time flies, I suppose. I never want to read a goodbye in these letters. It's an awful word. Causes lots of pain. If I could, I would head out into the cosmos and make it disappear. It's done enough damage, lost enough people. Time to retire. Anyway, Anthony is going to be a journalist, you say? Wow. He'll be a great one. One of my best friends was a journalist, you know? Again, time flies. Isn't it funny how a clock's hands move when you don't look at them? Sorry, I'm rambling again. A letter. Yes, yes, I suppose that'll be okay. Don't deliver it personally, mind you. Promise me this won't be the end. Please, Pond. Please don't forget to write to me. Don't forget to keep telling your story to me. With love, the Doctor. Don't talk to me like that. It's the last one. You're going to scan the bookplate and it's going to be her last words written to me. There's a reason I'd locked it away. I tear out the last page of every book I read. But what do you do when there's a book compiled of last pages? All these letters. I've been drawn in, living some past that I don't belong in. Thinking it's been a-okay. I haven't felt so alive typing back to a ghost. Yes. Yes, print it. Please, let's get it over with. Rip the plaster off.
Dear Doctor, it's 1996, and we've had such a long, fulfilling life. Anthony graduated. NYU. He's a proper journalist, telling stories of the people, those unheard by the masses. It's what we taught him together. It's Easter time. The weather's perfect for Rory's allotment. He bought a trowel, and if I knew anything about gardening, I'd be out there now tending to whatever he started growing. Time has caught up to us. To Rory? It's been about 3 years since the last letter. I'm sorry, I probably won't write another book. I'm getting more and more tired. Even with these really old new computers. It's why the book plate looks a little different. I keep forgetting things here and there. Even you, adventures we've had. I'm having to reread my books just to gather fragments. I miss you, and I know you've missed us. We got your letters every day. Right after I finished each book plate, you went out and you found my books just like I asked you to. But I have a feeling you've lost yourself in them, trying to relive the time we had. I'm sorry, Doctor. These started as something nice, a way to keep in touch. But I've lured you away from being a raggedy man for someone else. How long have you stayed in the TARDIS? You haven't left it, have you? You probably dropped River back at Stormcage. Where did you land your TARDIS after that? Did you do what I asked you to do in the afterward page?
I did. I did what you asked, Amy. You know that I did.
I know that you would have. You gave that girl hope when you had none left in you. But where have you been since then? Alone and distraught. All those places you wrote to me and Rory about, you never went to those places, did you? You've stayed in the TARDIS the whole time. You had all of my books already. You've got so much junk in that TARDIS. You need a fresh slate. You need to let us go.
I can't.
You need to be the hope for others now.
I don't know if I can. But where it got you both. To the others I've travelled with.
You've never left our side since the day our names appeared on the gravestones. I know it's going to be hard. These letters are proof that me and Rory have lived a life you would be proud of. Rory's letter, he handed it to Anthony to pass down to his granddad in 2012. So this is it, Raggedy Man. Write to me one last time. Promise me you're okay.
Okay, I will. Let me just set the paper. You weren't there before. Not a Melody Malone novel. Summer Falls by Amelia Williams. An envelope. A bookmark, maybe? Who needs that larger bookmark to remember what page they're on? I mean, it's better than dog-earing the corner, I suppose. God, I hate that. A letter to the doctor. Doctor. My mother and your best friend passed away last week. The service was nice, lots of friends and lots of family. Having heard so much about you from my childhood, I hope to meet you in person. To shake your hand and get to the bottom of if she really was telling the truth or not. Mum said in her dying days that she hoped you wouldn't be at the funeral, that you'd be too busy. I asked why that would have been a good thing, and all she said was that you had to move on. But before you moved on, I wanted to thank you for the joy you gave me, my mum, my dad. They'd have the biggest smile when they talked about you, wrote to you. At times it felt like they wanted to go back to those times so desperately. That I was their distraction.
That took a long time for them to stop talking about you. But your letters kept coming, like an old wound opening, over and over again. It's my turn to tell you about me. My name is Anthony Brian Williams. I'm 66 years old, and at least 30 years older than my grandfather, by the way. I lived my life with your stories in my heart, and through the power of words and compassion you preached so much, I became a journalist. I helped people, honest to God, save lives and expose wrongdoings in my city. It's not liberating planets, but it's something. Am I right? By the time you read this, I'll have traveled to London with my letter for my grandfather. I had to choose between meeting an imaginary friend or my own family. I hope you understand that this letter is a compromise. The book Summer Falls is my mom's last book, chapter 11 being my favorite. I hope that after reading this letter, you can leave this graveyard and help others into telling their own stories.
I made my mom and dad proud. I hope I've made you proud too. With thanks, Anthony. Well, goodbye, Ponds.
Thank you.